Namaste. I am Dr. Anchit from Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Pune University, from the Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. Today, we are going to continue our e-lectures, and the topic that we are going to pick today is physical dimensions of fitness. There are five dimensions of physical fitness, that is, promoting and maintaining physical fitness through different fitness training exercises lead to numerous health benefits. However, it should be noted that training programs or exercise regimes should be aligned with end goals. These goals are based on five dimensions of physical fitness. Physical strength. Physical strength or power is the ability of an individual to carry out his or her weight and even lift heavy objects without the assistance from others. Muscular capacity and body composition determines this dimension of physical fitness. Hence, it also corresponds to the amount of force the muscle of an individual can exert, as well as the number of repetitive contractions against the resistance these muscles can sustain over a period. That is called the endurance. Examples of activities for physical fitness aimed at improving physical strength include all forms of strength training and resistance exercises as a bodyweight workout and weightlifting. Second is cardiovascular endurance. Cardiovascular endurance or cardiorespiratory fitness is another dimension of physical fitness defined as the capacity of the circulatory and respiratory system to effectively and efficiently transport blood and oxygen to active muscles of the body and different parts of the body. This is measured by suitable heart rate levels, lung capacity, and metabolic rate. Activities aimed at promoting cardiovascular endurance include brisk walking, jogging, running, dancing, swimming, biking, as well as playing certain sports such as basketball, lawn tennis, badminton, etc. Then comes balance. Balance enables an individual to sustain equilibrium or to maintain the line of gravity of his or her body within the base of support with minimal to zero posture sway. Note that there are two types of balances, static and dynamic. Static balance is about maintaining equilibrium when stationary or while at rest. Dynamic balance is involved in maintaining equilibrium when moving. Examples of activities aimed at developing this dimension of physical fitness include lower body strength training, Pilates exercises, and yoga. Flexibility. Flexibility is determined by the capacity to perform bodily movements in different ranges of motion or move the joints within the respective full range of motion. Improving and maintaining flexibility also improves balance and mobility, while also allowing an individual to perform other physical activities without the risk of pain. Stretching exercises, Pilates workouts, and yoga can help promote and improve this dimension of physical fitness. Coordination. Coordination is the ability to combine and control multiple movements at once with effectiveness and efficacy. This is a dimension of physical fitness that is complex because it requires good balance, physical strength, and flexibility. That is a combination of all above. It is also an essential component of different sports. Some examples of activities aimed at developing coordination include obstacle course training, specific agility training, and other types of balance and strengthening exercises. These were a brief about the five dimensions of physical fitness. I hope the session is clear to you. In case of any doubt, you can comment. Thank you. Namaste. I am Dr. Anchit from Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Pune University, from the Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. Today, we are going to continue our e-lectures, and the topic that we are going to pick today is physical dimensions of fitness. There are five dimensions of physical fitness, that is, promoting and maintaining physical fitness through different fitness training exercises lead to numerous health benefits. However, it should be noted that training programs or exercise regimes should be aligned with end goals. These goals are based on five dimensions of physical fitness. Physical strength. Physical strength or power is the ability of an individual to carry out his or her weight and even lift heavy objects without the assistance from others. Muscular capacity and body composition determines this dimension of physical fitness. Hence, it also corresponds to the amount of force the muscle of an individual can exert, as well as the number of repetitive contractions against a resistance these muscles can sustain over a period. That is called the endurance. Example of activities for physical fitness aimed at improving physical strength include all forms of strength training and resistance exercises as a bodyweight workout and weightlifting. Second is cardiovascular endurance. Cardiovascular endurance or cardiorespiratory fitness is another dimension of physical fitness defined as the capacity of the circulatory and respiratory system to effectively and efficiently transport blood and oxygen to active muscles of the body and different parts of the body. This is measured by suitable heart rate levels, lung capacity, and metabolic rate. Activities aimed at promoting cardiovascular endurance include brisk walking, jogging, running, dancing, swimming, biking, as well as playing certain sports such as basketball, lawn tennis, badminton, etc. Then comes balance. Balance enables an individual to sustain equilibrium or to maintain the line of gravity of his or her body within the base of support with minimal to zero posture sway. Note that there are two types of balances, static and dynamic. Static balance is about maintaining equilibrium when stationary or while at rest. Dynamic balance is involved in maintaining equilibrium when moving. Examples of activities aimed at developing this dimension of physical fitness include lower body strength training, Pilates exercises, and yoga. Flexibility. Flexibility is determined by the capacity to perform bodily movements in different ranges of motion or move the joints within the respective full range of motion. Improving and maintaining flexibility also improves balance and mobility, while also allowing an individual to perform other physical activities without the risk of pain. Stretching exercises, Pilates workouts, and yoga can help promote and improve this dimension of physical fitness. Coordination. Coordination is the ability to combine and control multiple movements at once with effectiveness and efficacy. This is a dimension of physical fitness that is complex because it requires good balance, physical strength, and flexibility, that is a combination of all above. It is also an essential component of different sports. Some examples of activities aimed at developing coordination include obstacle course training, specific agility training, and other types of balance and strengthening exercises. These were a brief about the five dimensions of physical fitness. I hope the session is clear to you. In case of any doubt, you can comment. Thank you. Namaste. I am Dr. Anchit from Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University from the Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. Today, we are going to continue our e-lectures, and the topic that we are going to pick today is physical dimensions of fitness. There are five dimensions of physical fitness, that is promoting and maintaining physical fitness through different fitness training exercises lead to numerous health benefits. However, it should be noted that training programs or exercise regimes should be aligned with end goals. These goals are based on five dimensions of physical fitness. Physical strength. Physical strength or power is the ability of an individual to carry out his or her weight and even lift heavy objects without the assistance from others. Muscular capacity and body composition determines this dimension of physical fitness. Hence, it also corresponds to the amount of force the muscle of an individual can exert, as well as the number of repetitive contractions against a resistance these muscles can sustain over a period. That is called the endurance. Example of activities for physical fitness aimed at improving physical strength include all forms of strength training and resistance exercises as a bodyweight workout and weightlifting. Second is cardiovascular endurance. Cardiovascular endurance or cardiorespiratory fitness is another dimension of physical fitness defined as the capacity of the circulatory and respiratory system to effectively and efficiently transport blood and oxygen to active muscles of the body and different parts of the body. This is measured by suitable heart rate levels, lung capacity, and metabolic rate. Activities aimed at promoting cardiovascular endurance include brisk walking, jogging, running, dancing, swimming, biking, as well as playing certain sports such as basketball, lawn tennis, badminton, etc. Then comes balance. Balance enables an individual to sustain equilibrium or to maintain the line of gravity of his or her body within the base of support with minimal to zero posture sway. Note that there are two types of balances, static and dynamic. Static balance is about maintaining equilibrium when stationary or while at rest. Dynamic balance is involved in maintaining equilibrium when moving. Examples of activities aimed at developing this dimension of physical fitness include lower body strength training, Pilates exercises, and yoga. Flexibility. Flexibility is determined by the capacity to perform bodily movements in different ranges of motion or move the joints within the respective full range of motion. Improving and maintaining flexibility also improves balance and mobility, while also allowing an individual to perform other physical activities without the risk of pain. Stretching exercises, Pilates workouts, and yoga can help promote and improve this dimension of physical fitness. Coordination. Coordination is the ability to combine and control multiple movements at once with effectiveness and efficacy. This is a dimension of physical fitness that is complex because it requires good balance, physical strength, and flexibility, that is the combination of all above. It is also an essential component of different sports. Some examples of activities aimed at developing coordination include obstacle course training, specific agility training, and other types of balance and strengthening exercises. These were a brief about the five dimensions of physical fitness. I hope the session is clear to you. In case of any doubt, you can comment. Thank you. Namaste. I am Dr. Anchit from Jyoti Vidyapeeth, Women's University, from the Faculty of Physiotherapy and Diagnostics. Today, we are going to continue our e-lectures, and the topic that we are going to pick today is physical dimensions of fitness. There are five dimensions of physical fitness, that is promoting and maintaining physical fitness through different fitness training exercises lead to numerous health benefits. However, it should be noted that training programs or exercise regimes should be aligned with end goals. These goals are based on five dimensions of physical fitness. Physical strength. Physical strength or power is the ability of an individual to carry out his or her weight and even lift heavy objects without the assistance from others. Muscular capacity and body composition determines this dimension of physical fitness. Hence, it also corresponds to the amount of force the muscle of an individual can exert, as well as the number of repetitive contractions against a resistance these muscles can sustain over a period. That is called the endurance. Example of activities for physical fitness aimed at improving physical strength include all forms of strength training and resistance exercises as a bodyweight workout and weightlifting. Second is cardiovascular endurance. Cardiovascular endurance or cardiorespiratory fitness is another dimension of physical fitness defined as the capacity of the circulatory and respiratory system to effectively and efficiently transport blood and oxygen to active muscles of the body and different parts of the body. This is measured by suitable heart rate levels, lung capacity, and metabolic rate. Activities aimed at promoting cardiovascular endurance include brisk walking, jogging, running, dancing, swimming, biking, as well as playing certain sports such as basketball, lawn tennis, badminton, etc. Then comes balance. Balance enables an individual to sustain equilibrium or to maintain the line of gravity of his or her body within the base of support with minimal to zero posture sway. Note that there are two types of balances, static and dynamic. Static balance is about maintaining equilibrium when stationary or while at rest. Dynamic balance is involved in maintaining equilibrium when moving. Examples of activities aimed at developing this dimension of physical fitness include lower body strength training, Pilates exercises, and yoga. Flexibility. Flexibility is determined by the capacity to perform bodily movements in different ranges of motion or move the joints within the respective full range of motion. Improving and maintaining flexibility also improves balance and mobility, while also allowing an individual to perform other physical activities without the risk of pain. Stretching exercises, Pilates workouts, and yoga can help promote and improve this dimension of physical fitness. Coordination. Coordination is the ability to combine and control multiple movements at once with effectiveness and efficacy. This is a dimension of physical fitness that is complex because it requires good balance, physical strength, and flexibility. That is a combination of all above. It is also an essential component of different sports. Some examples of activities aimed at developing coordination include obstacle course training, specific agility training, and other types of balance and strengthening exercises. These were a brief about the five dimensions of physical fitness. I hope the session is clear to you. In case of any doubt, put in a comment. Thank you.